Karamoja State Minister and Bududa Woman Member of Parliament Agnes Nandutu was set to return to the Anti-Corruption Court today for the commencement of her trial. However, the trial did not kick off as the trial judge was absent. She was instructed to return to court on the 27th of July. Minister Agnes Nandutu is charged with dealing with suspect property, contrary to Section 21A1 of the Anti-Corruption Act. Prosecution states that in June 2022 at the Office of Prime Minister Stores in Namave, Mukono District and Kola Cell, Bulwani Parish in Mukono District, Nandutu dealt with 2,000 pre-painted iron sheets of gauge 28 by receiving and holding the said iron sheets, which she had reason to believe were acquired as a result of loss of public property, an offence under Section 10(1) of the Anti-Corruption Act of 2009. Also, Naweru Magistrate Court has dismissed an application by 11 people charged with being in possession of explosives to be tried by the Constitutional Court. The 11 had filed the application before the Grade 1 Magistrate and asked that the charges against them be dismissed or the matter be taken to the Constitutional Court. However, Grade 1 Magistrate Christian Kibuka dismissed the application and adjourned the matter to the 18th of July.
Your Honor, allow me to first respond to your directive.
Counsel, respond to that.
Much obliged, Your Honor. Your Honor, should you allow the adjournment prayed for by the prosecution?
The 11 include Katumba Abdul, Male Sulaiman, Masaba Farida, Magala Umal, Birunji Resten Nabosa, Muyodi Amidu, Makumbi Isa, Katumba Abdallah, Kaliango Muhammad, Sechide, Kairugara Wilba, and others. They are facing charges of terrorism after they were found in possession of improvised explosive devices. Meanwhile, legal practitioners in the country have asked the EAC member countries to consider redesigning their trade laws and policies to cater for the objectives of the East African Community integration. Former Uganda Law Society President Francis Gimara notes that whereas there is political will for free trade within the East African countries, the available laws remain a big impediment to the free movement of goods and services within the region.
You have passed a law on Bubu, but what does Bubu mean? That it should be only for Ugandans versus your commitments in the East African Community Treaty and the East African Customs Market Protocol? Is Bubu a law that is acceptable within the broader framework of EAC? Or you need to think of the laws you are doing by saying that it will not only advantage Ugandans, but should advantage East Africans. And the reasons for this is that the common market has more than 180 million people. So if we are speaking about a common market, we have to move the conversation from Uganda to the entire common market.
Meanwhile, the minister also launched the annual CSG scan report of the year 2022-2023.
So I now have the honor, dear friends, to launch the annual CSG scan 2022-2023 with appreciation to ALP East Africa, for God and my country.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.